Okay, welcome back to Elden Ring. So Digital Foundry did an article on, or a video on, exactly what's going on performance-wise, and it seems that we have an issue of shader caching with this game. So any new effect, boss attack, boss, anything like that is going to cause stuttering because it's being cached into the shader. Now, that's because of DX12 and the fact that this game apparently implemented DX12 in a very, very poor fashion. That's apparently the explanation behind this. Let's see what this guy is saying. A proper diff. Okay. Lots of blood stains over here. Oh, it's going away. Alright. I don't want to get hit by the bleeding. That would be a pretty bad situation. So, moving on. I know there is one that is going to shoot at me here. So, I just want to move through this. This is a mini dungeon. It's not a very long affair, I think. But there are, of course. Oh! Issues. Okay. Oh. Oh. Wow, talk about a lot of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, holy shit. That is not the joke right there. I can probably run for all of them though. And I will. Of intention. Okay. Well, that dealt with him. Still another one, huh? Be wary of fire. Yeah. As if we haven't gone through a bunch of fire to actually get this far. Hold on. Always look around the corner, because this is... this is still a Dark Souls game. I'm not gonna jump there. Not yet. Alright, throw your sticks, you little... Some bit of stuttering. I wonder what that's loading here. Oh yeah. Wandering noble ashes. Hold on. Not necessarily a really big dungeon, I can assure you of that one aspect. I mean, that's the entrance right there. Alright, switch to that. So ranged attacks can allow you to trigger the counter attack. Good. Okay. So there's a boss there. Wandering noble ashes. I wonder if I go outside, if it, no. All right. How do I summon these? Because yes, I would like the phantoms. Eh. Can't be that hard. Let's switch to that. The Earth Tree. Is it just me, or does it look a bit bugged? I Just saying. That animation looks a bit janky as fuck. Like when he's coming up here. Well, an interesting one. He's got independent movement of head. Okay, just gotta try and survive. I think the halberd is not necessarily the best option here. I'm gonna switch to the sword. Try summoning? Yeah, but how? Where did I die? Where did I die? Ah, there we go. Well, I'll figure it out eventually. Hmm. Be wary of fire. I don't think the fire is the issue. Because I don't see the issue with the fire. Turn, 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 turn. Oh, he is a bastard. Yeah, just stay away from the fire. And damn, I'm losing my voice. Okay. You just gotta be careful here, I think. Just, okay, enough. That bloody combo. Alright, fall back. The problem is he's like a stone. He's like made of stone, so I mean, he'll do it 3 times, best as I can tell. Visions of fire. I mean, is really the fire. Like, granted, maybe if you're playing another class where you have more movement at a range. Like, the problem is I'm wearing very heavy armor. And I'm very easy. Like, I can't really maneuver in the way I want. So I'm actually going to have to bump up my endurance level quite a bit in order to make do with that. Like, up to 15. Still not there. Let's see status. Let's see. So my equip load is 42 out of 56.1. And that's still not enough, by the way, to get the kind of movement range that I want. Alright, so I dealt with that. Those were some of the ruins. Like, this is the entire area. There might be a dungeon somewhere, like here or here. I'm actually just going to check that out. Because I want to know. Like, obviously, the Stormhill, the upper area that I just unlocked. Hold on. Alright, so that's not a spell. Anyway. No. Hold on. Okay, so RZ. Alright, let's try that again. I did manage to kill a source, though. At least I'll take comfort in that. In the knowledge of that. Oh, damn it. He does kill you that quickly. Like, if you get knocked off your horse, he'll just come in and finish you off very quickly. So, maybe not losing the horse. would be a great idea. Constant or respawning skeleton enemies. Welcome to Dark Souls 1, I suppose. The true color of Elden Ring is being revealed slowly but surely. It is truly Dark Souls 1, including the shitty performance and crap controls. And a really bad PC version. Let's not forget that aspect. Can't really have a Dark Souls game on PC without really a shitty PC performance. And mouse acceleration. You think I'm not seeing you, boy. You are dead wrong. So we got some constant respawning skeletons. Bloodstain. Someone died here. Quite a few people died. If you think I'm walking into that. Baggers. Let's see what happens. Okay, why did I switch my shield? Oh, really? It was a trap. I couldn't admit. I was actually surprised that for a second it didn't trigger, but then it's like, yep, there's our trap that we all expected. I mean, come on. Reminded of Blighttown. Can't imagine. Well, at least they don't have toxin darts. That would be a rather unfortunate turn of events, wouldn't it? Maybe the best way to dealing with that, but the question is, where would the trap spring from? Maybe side by side. I need to find the holes for the darts. Figure out how that trap is activated to maybe use it against them. Because that's where the boss is gonna be. Don't wanna lose those souls. Oh, I got stuck in the fucking door. Huh. Great stuff. Really great stuff. How did I get stuck in the door? I don't know. It's like, there should be enough space. Clearly it is. I might lose the souls. Oh yeah. It's gotta be side by side. Oh wait. Oh. Okay. There we go. Okay. What's the best solution over here? He is really aggressive, which is gonna cause plenty of problems. Parrying him is gonna be... an interesting challenge. At least I can get to him, consistently. Looks like I'm... yeah. This is the kind of boss where bringing a buddy may very well help a great deal compared to dealing with him on your own. Like, there's quite a few bosses in the Soul series where... And it's not because of, like, the extra damage that someone, that a friend would bring or summons or whatever. It comes down to the benefit of generally just having someone to take his fucking attention. What do these messages say? Alright, so I may need to switch back to my initial shield because it does have a parry option. And that parry... yeah, that parry might be the key here. Because without it, like, without just being able to parry his attacks, I'm not gonna get anywhere, clearly. So the problem with this shield that I picked up, it does have better stats, but it does not have a parry function. Compared to this one. Or it doesn't have a weapon art, specifically. So, the default shield you start with is a pretty solid option, because of that specific aspect. Or at least the shield you start with as the Vagabond. I don't know about other shields. I'm not getting I'm trying to get it. Yeah, just a question of mastering them parries. If I can consistently get parries on this guy, I can probably win, decently enough, the Grave Warden Duelist. I do like the fact that these bosses, like, they don't necessarily have the craziest amount of HP. They're not very long fights, but they are fights where you do actually have to play the mechanics from the very start. Well, not the very start, the tutorial guy who's pathetically easy, but the Godric Knight. But outside of that, the other enemies, yeah, you actually have to play for it. Now, I admit, if I could, this guy is gonna kill me. Okay. Let me just see something, because I'm kind of getting tired of this situation. Like, or one thing I'm actually interested in figuring out. Oh yeah, I kind of messed up, but all right, let's see if I remove all of it. So that's the most you can jump. Maybe you need some items. I'm darking her in terms of dodge range. great stuff. Grave Warden Duelist. A Marmillo. That's what he is. A Marmillo with hammers. Very, very fast hammers. Alright, last flask of Crimson Tears. Let me die near the entrance. I know I'm probably gonna die. If I kill him here, that's great, but... I'll take it. Oh, dead. Yeah, that was close, but unfortunate. Damn, the parry timings are rough, though. Or can be. Is this a mini Artorias of the Abyss? Fails in some way. One more parry, and we will send the Grave Duelist back to the hell he belongs in. It is finished. Imagine killing this boss with like 1 HP, then this guy comes around and it's like, bam, dead. No. Not yet. So these are the tree guardians. What did I get there though? Well, that was a battle hammer that he just dropped as an item. That's a mushroom, that's our way out. Now the problem here is I can kill that guy however many way many times I want. It will not work. Whoopsie on my part. I think I want to kill him. You know, I can't say exactly that I'm going to enjoy what lies ahead. In fact, I'm probably gonna hate it.
If it isn't Nereus, the bloody finger, the end is nigh. For you and your cessblood.
Okay, well, that's interesting. So a bit of an RP event. Need to try and win this and keep that NPC alive. Yeah, it would be the goal, wouldn't it? The problem is those daggers that he has, yeah, they're not gonna do much damage, but that bloodlust is gonna hurt me. All right, Nereus, round two. I think I need to try and parry this boy as well. If I'm going to succeed here. And I'm gonna switch the sword. Probably better to, the halberd's great because of its reach, but it's not so great when you're trying to hit a fast moving enemy like him. Okay, here he comes. All right, it might be difficult. Bloody Finger Hunter. Switch my shield around. Yeah, getting a parry off on that boy is gonna be a tricky affair. Might as well have the better shield. All right, Nereus. Just gonna wait for this bullet to go down. Where is that Yura fella? Oh, here, there he is. Thank you.
Well, thought you'd just help yourself to a man's personal belongings, huh? You scheming little thief! The gods demand repentance! Cough up your coin! All of it!
Oh.
Okay.
I surrender. White flag and all. Well, finally come round, have you? I knew you would. You're a lady of reason, through and through. Ah. Well, what do you know? You're tarnished, like me. Now, how did I get that wrong? I took you for a demi-human or some such. An innocent mistake, I assure you. Well, water under the bridge. Now we're squared up. How about we play nice from now on? A true lady of reason. Just what I like about you. I'm Patches. Patches the Untethered. Tarnished like you, only free-spirited. Nomadic, you might say. Only for now. Those retired soldiers turned bandits. And they're paying for my gruel. In exchange for my, well, showing them the ropes. But honestly, this looting racket is bloody terrifying. Frankly, I'm ready to wash my hands clean. Maybe set up a legitimate shop. So don't be a stranger. I'll be ready to wheel and deal come next time. Don't forget to pop back for another visit, friend.
All right, back to the entrance then.
Pleasure to meet thee, Tarnished. I am the witch Renna. I'd heard tell of a Tarnished hurtling about atop a spectral steed, and upon looking into the matter, the talk, I surmise, is of thee. Thou art possessed of the power, no? To call forth a spectral steed named Torrent. Ah, as I had hoped, I was entrusted this for thee. By Torrent's former master. Tis a bell for calling forth spirits. Summon them with it. From ash and return to the Erdtree, the spirits will obey thine command but briefly. As they recall battles past, now it is thine to do with as thou wishest. Forgive mine intrusion, Tarnished. I doubt we shall again meet. But all the same, learn well the lands between. How long will it be, I wonder, before the Tarnished tire of obeisance to the two fingers?
This tiny golden aura is the grace of the Erdtree. This light once shone in the eyes of your tarnished brethren, but now it is all that guides you. Also, I hear. You can see them, can't you? The rays of grace that guide you through your burden. Upon the cliff, in Castle Stormvale, is a Shardbearer, a demigod, who inherited a fragment of the shattered Elden Ring. If the rays of grace signal the castle, then the Elden Ring beckons you. As an ally by pact, I pray that you are fit to face the challenge presented by the ring. Upon the cliff, in Castle Stormvale, is a Shardbearer, a demigod, who inherited a fragment of the shattered Elden Ring. If the rays of grace signal the castle, then the Elden Ring beckons you. As an ally by pact, I pray that you are fit to face the challenge presented by the ring. Shall I turn your runes to strength? Let my hand rest upon you. For but a moment, share them with me. Your thoughts, your ambitions, the principles you would follow.
Okay, so got a start. There's still plenty of stuff around here that I do intend to explore around this place. There is a dragon somewhere around here that I do fully intend to find. There's something interesting on the road there, but I'll check that later. Costine signing out. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and enable notifications, and stay tuned for more. I'm not gonna rush for the castle. I do want to do a couple of things as well, like, oh, I don't know, maybe, yeah, make this halberd plus one. So, stay tuned.